Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. We've got a pretty interesting one to take a look at today. This is the 100/17 load of old ass. So this is a new Italian vehicle coming in the next major update, a danger zone. And it's also a user-made vehicle, as far as I'm aware. And it's also another wheeled vehicle, which I'm definitely not complaining about. Most of the ground vehicles that have been showcased, at least through the official development blog news so far, has been wheeled units, which I am very, very happy to see. As I explained in a previous devlog video, I think that wheeled units are, while obviously tanks are badass, wheeled units have a very special place and are unique and fun enough to drive just because they're wheeled. But let's go ahead and take a closer look at this. So created by players for players, the 117 was a field modification of the Italian military transport truck during the North African campaign of World War II. Soon, the punch of the 117 will join the low ranks of the Italian ground forces tree in War Thunder, coming to the game as part of the next major update, Danger Zone. So it's an Italian SPG based on the chassis of that truck, equipped with a powerful 100mm howitzer with high destruction shells. It is this new truck. It's an SPG for Italy of the first rank. It features a devastating 100mm gun, and the rest of them are downsides, but it is exposed to enemy fire. Obviously, all of the crew, including the driver and what looks to be a front forward facing machine gunner, which is pretty badass, are completely exposed. There's no shielding, no armor to speak of, no glass or anything. There are limited aiming angles, so, for example, I'm assuming that, as you can see here, the gun is lifted up slightly when it's aimed forward. You can't aim down or direct in front of you if you're on level ground, and it also has poor mobility on soft ground, which is to be expected from a lot of these older wheeled vehicles, and wheeled vehicles in general tend to struggle off-road. So here's some history on the unit if you are interested. Okay, moving on. Here we've got some screen shits of the vehicle. Very nice tan paint there. This, I don't know, I love this machine gun. Honestly, my favorite part about this truck is the machine gun, which I think is hilarious. But really, I am just excited to see another wheeled vehicle in what has already been mostly wheeled vehicles that they've shown us, as far as ground vehicles are concerned. And then you got this big old stubby howitzer to go right on the back of it. So in War Thunder, the 117 will join the ranks of the Italian ground forces arriving in the game's next major update, Danger Zone. Thanks to its main 100mm howitzer and capable ammunition, this truck can deal truly lethal damage even to more heavily armored or protected tanks that it can face in battle. Commanders will have the choice between solid anti-concrete shells and very rare, at low ranks, HESH rounds that are perfectly effective against any low-rank opponent. Fun fact, to install the howitzer on the chassis, the engineers used an M13/40 turret ring-welded to the original field mount. There you go, some fun fact history there. However, the powerful gun and comparatively large crew are fully exposed to enemy fire, including rifle caliber MGs, so any opponent is able to instantly remove the brave Italians on sight. The 117 is a pretty huge vehicle and can be easily spotted by attacker or fighter pilots. The wheel that doesn't fucking matter. It doesn't matter what the hell you're driving. So that's not a downside with this vehicle in particular. The 117 is a pretty huge I already said that. The wheeled truck itself, equipped with a not-so-powerful engine, will decrease the mobility on soft ground, making it tricky to escape from ambushers or difficult situations. The vehicle is more suited as a second-line support to immobilize or finish off any opponents already engaged by allies. That being said, though, due to its limited firing arc, you can back this thing up into a position and then pull out by driving forward to get away back behind cover. You don't have to back up or rely on backing up. So it's one of those vehicles that you'll probably, when you find a position or you're getting into a position or a defensive position or whatever you're trying to do, you'll probably turn the truck around and back it into a spot to fire at the enemy, which is very effective on vehicles like this, though obviously you are still very exposed. But you will have two crew members, one driver and a machine gunner, in case you lose all of your turret crew or gun crew. You'll have somebody to replace at least the gunner and loader. So there's that. And here we got some screenshots with a nice looking paint scheme there on the truck. The Italian paint also on the truck, which also looks pretty good. I think I like this one more here though. And then we have another camouflage. I like it when they do this. I wish they would do this for every single vehicle. They do it a lot nowadays, but I like when they show us the vehicle in various camouflages, just to show kind of what you can expect to see from some base customization. So it was created by War Thunder players Nicola Colin Zero, I guess, or Colin Zero, and Fagiani. I'm very sorry about butchering your name. And Ricardo Blue Beta Loverso, as part of the revenue and share program, and will be soon arriving in War Thunder. So this is, of course, credit goes to our players for this, which is awesome to see that players are still creating vehicles and Gaijin is still accepting some projects into the game. This is two-wheeled Italian vehicles coming for the next major update. And this one's also really, really, really awesome looking. Just not necessarily for its combat capability, but just because of how it looks. I mean, it's a fucking truck with the canopy ripped off and a big old derp thing on the back. I don't know. It just looks, it looks fun just to drive around. But yeah, that's that. So if you haven't been paying attention to the news, here are the other vehicles. For ground forces, specifically, Italy is also receiving the VBC PT-2, a new infantry fighting vehicle. The British tech tree is receiving the G6 Rhino South African Mobile Artillery Unit, both of which, that I mentioned, are wheeled. And the French are also getting the new wheeled VCAC Mephisto, which is a... an APC that's been outfitted with anti-tank guided missiles, and it's also amphibious. So for that, four announced wheeled vehicles so far, and the only other ground unit officially announced as of right now is the Swedish PVKV-3 tank destroyer, which is a further variant of the PVKV with a smaller gun but a faster fire rate. Although I am aware that people have made sure to let me know, I did not get a hold of the dev server myself, but by God did I have about 47 people tell me the ZTZ-99A is coming to the game with the next major update, or at least is on the dev server, the new Chinese main battle tank, which is going to be really fucking dope to see that in game. But they haven't done a dev blog on that, at least not yet. And then as for naval forces, we have two larger vessels, including the British HMS Hood battlecruiser and the German SMS Bayern dreadnought battleship. For aviation, we have the new French premium jet fighter that's on pre-order right now. It's a bundle pack premium. And the United States are receiving the F-14A Tomcat jet fighter for their naval tech line. So yeah, we'll get to that. We already got to that, but we'll get to that in the game. And then as for miscellaneous, there's a new air battle map known as the Southeastern City, which is this really detailed looking, or at least expansive looking, metropolis. Abandoned Town is a new ground battle map, and then they are also improving the existing Sun City map that was released with a recent update. So anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next War Thunder upcoming content video. Goodbye.